There's been another scare for the Police Eagle helicopter crew, the second in a week. A man's been charged after allegedly aiming a firearm at the chopper from the ground. The incident sparked a standoff at a house in Red Hills Road in Taupaki. The armed defenders squad leaving nothing to chance in a tricky situation. Ryan Boswell reports.
The early hours of the morning and the police helicopters checking out reports of a gun being fired at a rural address. The response unexpected.
We had our police helicopter Eagle here, and as they arrived on scene, they observed an address and they saw someone come out of that address and present a firearm at the Eagle helicopter.
The potential attack on the chopper prompting the armed defenders squad to be called in and cordons put in place. Sleeping residents didn't know it, but they were in lockdown.
Some people do stupid things. I have no idea what the motivation of that person was to aim a firearm at the helicopter. However, very shortly we'll find out when we get into that address and we speak to those people.
The operation involved 40 to 50 officers. Police were still at the scene at 6 a.m. and not taking any chances.
Well, it was quite difficult getting into the address because it was very dark and there was a level of risk when you're approaching an address where there's firearms concerned.
Police have questioned three people about last night's incident. A 43-year-old man has now been charged in relation to presenting a firearm and will appear in court at a later date. It's not the first scare this year for the Eagle crew. On New Year's Eve, a pilot was forced to take immediate evasive action to avoid colliding with a drone over Auckland CBD.
I'm of the firm belief that he potentially saved lives. If he hadn't have taken that evasive action, who knows what might have happened.
The Civil Aviation Authority is investigating both incidents.
Obviously, having a firearm presented to them is not something that you can dismiss.
The safety of police who work in our skies is essential. Ryan Boswell, One News.